Wei Jingsheng has learned to catch up on sleep whenever he can. The world's most prominent Chinese dissident has a punishing schedule, urging anyone who'll listen to support the democracy movement in China. And with the days ticking away before the Olympic Games, he's cranking up the pace.
I think all the dissidents will speak the same thing. Because this not only affects the Chinese people's interests, if China creates a large upheaval, all countries' interests will be affected.
London is the latest leg of his tireless campaign. A series of meetings with local activists, university students, and politicians.
They make everyone who go through there now.
Oh, good, yes, it's Stephen's Gate.
That's okay. The one, yeah. Good night.
Now, with his interpreter and human rights group Amnesty International's China campaign manager, he's off to the British Foreign Office.
The work we're doing on China at the moment is, especially with the UK government, is getting them to acknowledge that there's an increasing crackdown on human rights activists in China, and it always increases when you go up to June 4th, and to speak out more publicly about that crackdown.
What do you hope to achieve when you go into meetings like this?
就是说，希望那个英国的政治家能够推动中国政府进行一些改革，特别是政治上的改革。因为现在中国正处在一个十字路口的状况，所以说如果不赶快进行改革的话，那么中国可能面临着一个更大的动乱。
When the Mandarin-speaking Kevin Rudd became Prime Minister of Australia, Wei Jingsheng sat up and took notice.
懂得中国的事务的这个政治家，应该更加关心中国的人权，因为他自己生活在这个自由的国家里，他在从事着民主的政治，他应该是很懂民主的。所以，一般中国人的想象中，陆克文应该是对中国民主有更大的促进作用。
Wei Jingsheng once had impeccable Communist Party credentials. He was born into a high-ranking military official family and brought up in prestigious party schools. He was even a Red Guard in his youth. But he became disillusioned and in the 1970s started an underground magazine and began posting articles on what became known as Democracy Wall in downtown Beijing. He pushed the boundaries harder than anyone else, but seemed to get away with it for a while, until he posted a very critical essay about the then Premier, Deng Xiao Ping. 3 days later, on the 29th of March 1979, he was arrested and then put on a show trial. He spent the next 15 years in prison. Wei was released as China made its bid for the 2000 Olympic Games. But when the honor was bestowed on Sydney, the Chinese authorities locked him up again. President Clinton intervened and cut a deal to get him released after 3 years and deported to the US, where he now lives. The Chinese leadership, of course, just dismiss you as a stooge of the CIA. What do you say to that?
那中央情报局可是有了一个特别高级的特务了。实际上，我跟中央情报局没有任何关系。Shortly
after his release from prison, Mr. Wei met Mr. Rudd in 1999. He says the then opposition parliamentarian showed him his university thesis, which focuses on him and outlines his key role in the early democracy movement. It's a highly detailed dissertation which conveys Rudd's clear admiration for his strength, courage, and commitment. Mr. Wei is now calling on Mr. Rudd, the Prime Minister, to resurrect his university idealism and use his influence to push Beijing to reform.
但是目前的很多事情，包括他竞选时期和现在那个当选以后的一些情况呢，我们没有看他做什么。我现在对他还并没有失望，但是呢。 我觉得他到这么长时间什么都没有做的话，我们可能得督促他一下，得给他一些新的信息，促使他去做一些事情。我准备过一段时间稍微
Mr. Wei is now the chairman of the Overseas Chinese Democracy Coalition in Washington, D.C. He spends his life lobbying policymakers and politicians for support. But Mr. Wei admits to a second agenda. Many times on this trip, I hear people say that China's rapid development has lifted millions out of poverty, and improving human rights will follow. Mr. Wei scoffs at the idea that the economy should come first. Shouldn't we just be patient and let things happen on their own?
中国老百姓已经给了中国政府60年的时间了，60年现在还改成那个很糟糕的状况。
Amnesty International have brought Mr. Wei to London for a series of events to commemorate the 1989 Tiananmen Square massacre, where hundreds of pro-democracy activists and students were killed. They wanted to recreate the iconic scene of that time, when a lone protester with a shopping bag faces off a Chinese tank. Mr. Wei was to have played the part of the protester, but he didn't make it in time, and they had to get a stand-in. But he did make it to the main memorial event across town a few days later, which was closely monitored from the Chinese embassy over the road.
你好，魏京生。对对对，受苦了，我是龚俊。啊，你好，你好。我有两颗牙，而且一点浮肿没有了，就基本上恢复的正常了。我看你转寒凉，或者你当初来时候挺惨的。啊，对对，脸都是浮肿的。
咱俩都是牙都掉了。对，我这也是，我牙掉光，你看你全是假的。
But in prison, he was subjected to torture, brutal physical and psychological abuse, including solitary confinement and physical attacks. He has subsequently been awarded the Olaf Palme Peace Prize in 1995, the Sakharov Prize for Freedom of Thought in 1996, and he is a nominee for the Nobel Peace Prize. Please welcome him to the stage.
The brutal crackdown in Tiananmen Square 19 years ago was a pivotal event in modern Chinese history, and a memory the Chinese government tries very hard to suppress.
有些人说那是已经是过去的事情了，我要说那不是过去的事情，那是现在还在发生的事情。
Considering how hard the embassy is trying to put good spin on the Olympic Games, they would not have been pleased to hear Mr. Wei's call to arms here today.
Let's work hard together. Thank you very
much.
Thank you.
Mr. Wei believes that while the Chinese do not honor their promise to improve the human rights record, a precondition for holding the games, then world leaders like Kevin Rudd should reverse their decision to attend the opening ceremony.
这和你西方国家的价值观念是完全相反的，而且和你年轻和若的先生年轻的时候，他的理想也是完全相反的。所以我觉得这样做法，对他从他个人角度看是没有道理的。 从国家的民族社会的这个基本价值观念看，也是没有道理的，可能仅仅是对做生意是有道理的，所以我觉得这样做法是错误的。这个奥运会就像1936年那个柏林奥运会一样，那就是对纳粹和专制主义者的一种支持。
Much was made of Prime Minister Rudd's raising of human rights in Beijing recently, where he used a 7th century word to describe his relationship with China. Zhengyou, the true friend who dares to disagree. Most analysts thought it was a brave move. Mr. Wei believes the opposite.
你要是共产党的朋友，你怎么会成为中国人民的朋友呢？这一点共产党自己就画得非常清楚，中国老百姓也把这个界限画得非常清楚，所以我觉得他提出这个概念是，可能是受到了大企业的很大的压力，他又想做中国的朋友，又想向西方的老百姓解释，我是关心人权的，所以他提出了这个很莫名其妙的、很奇怪的一个概念。
Can we schedule? Great. We need to also talk about the French Minister for Human Rights. Apparently, they want to meet.
I'm just thinking, gosh, he's got such a busy program. That's like the next thing he's going to go and speak at.
They're both losing their voices.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
Another day, another meeting. Mr. Wei is being briefed by his minders about Foreign Office Minister Lord Malik Brown.
I'm hopeful that'll be quite a useful meeting. Lord Malik Brown is a fairly sympathetic human rights minister. He's interested in actually understanding the issues and seeing what the UK can realistically do about things. So I think this should be quite a friendly meeting, but how far he'll be able to push his other colleagues in other parts of government to do the things we want them to do is the challenge he faces, I think.
What are you hoping to get out of this meeting? Is it the same as all of the others, just pushing the same ideas, or is there a different approach to this particular meeting?
As we leave the cafe and Mr. Wei heads off to his meeting, I'm stopped by police and questioned on suspicion of involvement in terrorism.
I'm just filming them.
This is everything is professional filming.
Huh?
We believe it's professional filming.
I just wanted to get the shot of them walking in, that's all.
We just get the shot of them walking in.
I didn't know till about 10 minutes ago what we were doing, you know? Like I said, you don't know from 1 minute to the next. Okay. News reporting. You follow the news.
Now, if you had the press pass, it would have helped as well.
It's also difficult to get Dateline's camera into any of the meetings Mr. Wei has with British politicians, not even to get the shot of them shaking hands. He really is a political hot potato. Mr. Wei says they have too much to lose in offending China by being seen meeting him.
我认为这个原因跟陆克文的原因差不多，也就是说他们那个，一方面要向那个大企业做交代，一方面又不愿意得罪老百姓。When
you met Kevin Rudd, it was also in secret?
当年他当议员的时候不会，现在我就不知道了，因为当议员的时候他可能不需要考虑那么多，但是他现在要考虑刚才说的那个问题，就是，你要是关心了人权，那么澳大利亚的资本家不高兴，你如果 不关心人权，那么澳大利亚老百姓不高兴。我到现在还没有跟他进行这方面联系。上次我去澳大利亚的时候，想他好像不是很热情。Today
it's off to Cambridge University for a speech to overseas Chinese students. He begins with the disturbing trend of rising nationalism in China, which he says is supported by the government.
这种极端民族主义已经表现出来一些类似于纳粹的这个特点，比如他非常的排外，非常的排斥异己，而且非常的暴力，而且他和所有的狂热一样，一旦进入狂热状态以后， 他们的耳朵里已经听不进任何东西了。那么这种狂热的极端的爱国主义发展下去会走到什么地步呢？不仅我们非常担心，而且连共产党内部的很多人也很担心。在他旁边的小学
校。He then went on to talk about organ harvesting.
因为大家都知道，中国现在已经不仅仅是摘取犯人的器官了，甚至摘取普通人的器官，甚至有在大街上把人抓去以后就给杀掉摘取器官的，因为这成为一笔大生意。就是说，我。
But when he criticized Premier Wen Jiabao and the Chinese military for getting to the recent earthquake zone too late, it was too much for some in the audience.
So my question is whether he really knows at what exactly time the Chinese troop arrived in the earthquake region.
行，先回答他的问题。
At this point, Mr. Wei got confused and contradicted himself, losing the attention of many in the audience. But at the end, he still got quite an applause, although mostly from the non-Chinese.
Any comment on that?
Very profound and very nice.
Then I see the student who questioned Mr. Wei's facts.
So, what did you think?
A bit disappointing.
A bit disappointing, why is that?
Really disappointing.
Why?
Well, I think you can see from my question, because
I
think it's not really well evidenced. Most stories he tells is about himself. It's not really something just happening there.
Any comment on what you heard just now?
Nonsense.
Okay. Nonsense? Really?
Yeah.
Can you tell me why?
Sorry, I have no time now.
No, just quickly, I'll walk with you. Why did you say nonsense?
I think he was just misleading us, misleading the foreign countries, the foreign media to convince them to overturn the Chinese government.
还没到那个时候，暂时还没到。
对，您自己觉得在将来这五六年到。
Other students agreed that he didn't answer their questions, but Mr. Wei dismisses the criticism.
年轻人嘛，有时候受欺骗太久了以后，都是这样。那这些年轻人可能要经过很长的时间，才能慢慢的懂得道理。这就是共产党洗脑的作用。
And he alleges that there were embassy officials sitting at the back of the theater.
How do you know the embassy sent some officials?
那他们学生告诉我的。
啊。
然后，而且我觉得这些学生还是相当友好了，我讲了很多东西，他们肯定已经听进去了，但是在大使馆官员的监视下，电视台采访他只能那么说。我相信如果没有大使馆官员在场，这帮小伙子肯定会拉着我喝啤酒去，他们还有没问完的问题呢。
Do you think you'll ever get to go back to China?
我想中国政府可能不会允许我，就共产党政府可能不会允许我回到中国。但是这个共产党政府呢，可能很快会垮台，这样我也会很快的回到中国。我的希望是越快越好。